On highways across the United States, the police are checking thousands of vehicles carrying such hazardous materials as gasoline, explosives, and chemicals. And they're also reviewing 2.5 million easy-to-get driver's licenses. Fearful any future terror attack could be delivered by truck, authorities are taking no chances, as CBS's Wyatt Andrews reports in tonight's Eye on America.
The search for terrorists potentially carrying hazardous materials has the look of a national shakedown. Here at the Manhattan-bound entrance to the Lincoln Tunnel, and here on I-95, the main East Coast highway, trucks are being stopped.
Back with you in a minute, sir.
And all licenses with what are called hazmat endorsements are being verified.
Are you able to cross-check the names of these drivers with the FBI's watch list?
Yes, we are.
Are you doing that actively?
Yes, sir, we are proactively doing that.
The alert was issued after the FBI in Pittsburgh charged 20 Arab Americans with buying fake licenses to transport hazardous materials. Was this a new bomb plot with chemicals or a simple scam for the drivers to inflate their resumes? The FBI admits none of the 18 men arrested is connected to the terrorists.
We do not believe that those currently under arrest as a result of the investigation in Pennsylvania are related to the hijackings.
At the same time, the FBI believes it had no choice but to issue this alert.
We are looking at individuals who have obtained hazmat licenses, and particularly those individuals that may have obtained them under suspicious circumstances, and we are tracking those leads.
Yeah. While most truck drivers take these inspections in stride,
I'd rather be safe than sorry.
Most experts in terrorism think the actual threat of a biochemical truck attack is low.
In past history has shown that conventional explosives do plenty of damage on their own.
Eric Crotty, who studies terrorism, points out the original Trade Center bombers used a conventional truck bomb simply because that was easier than chemicals or biologics.
Due to the technical hurdles and other complications that these types of weapons, namely biological but also chemical warfare agents, this complicates the picture on the operational level for the terrorist.
It's likely this won't be the first time Americans tolerate some inconvenience in the name of safety. Right now, no official in government wants to be first to take a threat lightly. Wyatt Andrews, CBS News, Washington.